Hello and good day to everyone. Today, me and my group members will discuss about frequency shift keying modulator.
First, let's see the definition of frequency shift keying. Frequency shift keying, FSK, is a digital modulation technique which allows the change of frequency of the carrier signal according to the voltage change of digital signals. It is also known as binary frequency shift keying as it only uses binary input. Let's see the definition of FSK modulator. It comprises of two oscillators with an inverter, a summing amplifier, and the input binary sequence. This is a FSK modulator. As we can see, there is two oscilloscope where it is inserted with carrier signals with different frequencies. Then, the binary data will be inserted where at the one side it will be non-inverted and the other side it will be inverted. And at the last point, a summing amplifier will add both the signals that produced.
Next, we are going to discuss about the generation of FSK signal. Phase shift in carrier frequency is proportional to amplitude of binary input signal, which is also known as information signal. As we can see that VCO, which is voltage control oscillator, is usually used in generating FSK signal because inside VCO, all mechanical mechanisms are presented. Therefore, when two different voltage signals are added together, it can produce two different frequency signals with the help of VCO based on the amplitude of information signal. Let's take a look at the general equation of FSK signal. As the equation is shown below, VFSK defines the binary FSK waveform, whereas EC is the peak analog carrier amplitude and its unit is volt. FC is the analog carrier center frequency and its unit is hertz. Delta F is the peak shift in analog carrier frequency, which is hertz. VM is the binary input signal and its unit is volt. The equation can be divided into two because it represents each of frequency signals produced in the FSK signal. One of the signal is positive with larger frequency, which can be seen as FC2 in the wave graph shown below. Whereas another frequency is negative with smaller frequency, and we can see that FC1 shown in the wave graph below is the minimal frequency. Let's analyze the general equation. First of all, using mathematical analysis, we need to make sure there are two ASK signals, which is amplitude shift keying signals, to be added, where one will be positive, another one will be inverted, which becomes negative. Since both information signals are opposite to each other, we need to use the equation VM2 equals to 1 minus VM1 to substitute VM2 in the equation. After that, using Fourier series, we need to find equations for VM1 and VM2 signals. Equation of VM2 will be slightly different from VM1 because it is inverted. You can refer the figure 1 as shown. For carrier signal, we need to be careful with conditions provided for both high and low frequencies, where both carrier frequencies must be higher compared to the information frequency. The fourth part shows the final equation of FSK signal after substituting everything in the general equation. Lastly, we can see the example of how FSK signal is generated in both time domain and frequency domain. Frequency of C1 signal indicates the lower frequency, whereas frequency of C2 indicates the higher frequency with same amplitude. As for the information signal, known as binary signal, will vary according to the square wave levels of the signal. Finally, after combining both signals with the help of VCO, a frequency shift keying signal is formed.
Let's find out how to calculate the bandwidth of frequency shift keying modulator. Remember that FSK has two different frequencies. In order to calculate the bandwidth, we have to know two important parameters, which are the bit rate and also the baud rate. Let's see what is mean by bit rate and also the baud rate. Bit rate is the number of bits delivered or received per second. The unit for bit rate is bits per second or BPS, while baud rate is the number of times a signal changes per second. The unit for baud rate is baud per second. Baud rate can be calculated by dividing the bit rate with number of bits per signal period. In binary frequency shift keying, the n is equals to 1. By substituting this value into the formula, we can see that the baud rate is equals to the bit rate. In FSK, the binary input will produce analog output. Since there are two different frequencies, one is labeled as FS while another one is labeled as FM. FS is the space frequency that refers to logic 0, while FM is the mark frequency that refers to logic 1. In order to find the frequency deviation, the differences between FS and also FM is divided by 2. Finally, to calculate the minimum bandwidth, the FS and also FM values must be subtracted with the bit rate, and then the differences between FS and FM is equal to frequency deviation. So by substituting frequency deviation, we will get the final formula.
Hi, do you know the advantages and disadvantages of frequency shift keying? The advantages are simple process to construct the circuit, zero amplitude variations, supports a high data rate, low probability of error, and high signal to noise ratio. The disadvantages of FSK are it requires more bandwidth than the ASK and PSK. Due to the requirement of large bandwidth, this FSK has limitations to use only in low speed modems, which the bit rate is 1200 bits per second. The bit error rate is less in AEGN channel than PSK.
Hello guys, now let's have a look at the applications of FSK modulator. Some of the examples of the applications of FSK modulators are caller ID on telephone systems, weather balloon radio sounds, emergency broadcast system, modem, and amateur radio. Now, let's see how does a caller ID work. To send caller ID information to your home, the phone company uses a FSK technique, which is an audio frequency shift keying technique identical to a 1200 baud modem, and it sends ASCII character data to the caller ID box. Bell 103 being the first commercial computer modem was introduced in 1965. It provided full duplex service at 300 bits per second and 300 baud over normal phone lines. It also has an originating frequency with mark tone of 1270 Hz and a space tone of 1070 Hz. It also has an answering frequency with mark tone of 2225 Hz and a space tone of 2025 Hz. The Bell 202 modem was introduced in 1976. It encodes and transfers data at a rate of 1200 bits per second, and it provides half duplex service. It also has a mark tone of 1200 Hz and a space tone of 2200 Hz. It's currently used for caller ID systems. The next application of FSK modulator is the weather balloon radio sound. Radiosondes are battery-powered telemetry instrument packages that are carried into the atmosphere typically by a weather balloon. They measure altitude, pressure, temperature, relative humidity, wind, and cosmic ray readings at high altitudes. The radio sound comprises of three major sections, which are a suite of sophisticated meteorological sensors, signal processing electronics, and a radio transmitter to relay the measurements back to a receiver at the radio sound launch station. The meteorological community has been assigned two radio frequency bands for use in transmitting meteorological data, and this frequency ranges from 400.15 to 406 MHz and 1668.4 till 1700 MHz. Now, let's have a clearer picture on how a weather balloon radio sound works.
Ever wonder what it takes to make a weather forecast? Well, if you break it down, you really need three things. A sophisticated mathematical model with equations that precisely describe how the atmosphere works, a fast supercomputer to run all of those calculations quickly, and accurate observations that describe the current atmospheric conditions, at the Earth's surface, but especially at upper levels of the atmosphere. Where do these observations come from? Surface data comes from weather stations over land and buoys over the ocean. Observations at upper levels comes from radars, satellites, and aircrafts. But the most important source of upper air observations comes from weather balloons. But while weather balloons are fun and get all the glory, the most important part of the weather balloon is hanging on a string underneath, called the radio sonde. Radio, because it uses a UHF radio transmitter, and sonde from the French meaning probe. The radio sonde carries sensors that measure temperature, air pressure, humidity, and GPS location from which winds and altitude are calculated. The radio transmitter sends that information back to ground stations where the data are collected and used for forecasts. That's not all the data are used for. We use it for local severe storm prediction, aviation, and marine forecasts. Field programs to study specific atmospheric phenomena like severe thunderstorms, tornadoes, monsoons, and hurricanes. It's used for ground truthing, where observations are compared to check the accuracy of radar and satellite data. And the data are also plugged into many different kinds of useful modeling tools, which can help predict river and stream levels, the onset of drought, pollution and air quality, and even the spread of certain mosquito-borne diseases.
Moving on to the next application of FSK Modulator is the emergency broadcast system. Japan has an emergency broadcast system which is called the emergency warning system. It utilizes a multiplex digital alarm signal on the audio courier wave. It is transmitted at 64 bits per second, and its signal contains area division and date and time along with the start and end signals. This frequency has a marked tone of 1024 Hz and a space tone of 640 Hz. The US also has the emergency broadcast system, which is called the Emergency Alert System. And the Emergency Alert System is a national public warning system that requires radio and TV broadcasters, cable systems, satellite and wireline operators to provide the president with capability to address the American people within 10 minutes during a national emergency. And FSK is used as a header tone for the warning called the same header. It uses an alternating tones of 853 Hz and 960 Hz. Last but not least, the amateur radio is also one of the applications of FSK modulator. The amateur radio is the use of radio frequency spectrum for purposes of non-commercial exchange of messages, wireless experimentation, self-training, private recreation, radio sports, and emergency communication. Radio amateurs are limited to the use of small frequency bands, which are called the amateur radio bands, allocated throughout the radio spectrum. But within these bands are allowed to transmit on any frequency using a variety of voice, text message, and data communication modes. Radio amateurs use a variety of transmission modes, including the Morse code, radio teletype, data, and voice. Specific frequency allocations vary from country to country and between ITU regions as specified in the current ITU HF frequency allocation for amateur radio. The list of frequency ranges is called a band allocation.
Let me summarize this. FSK is a digital modulation technique where the frequency of the signal varies between two discrete voltages, which is 0 and 1. It is also known as binary frequency shift keying. FSK modulator consists of an inverter, mixer and summing amplifier. FSK waveform can be achieved by generating two amplitude shift keying waveform and adding them together with a summing amplifier. I hope that you guys remember the modulator's diagram. This is the equation of FSK signal. This equation can be obtained after the signal is modulated. Then, the meaning of bit rate is number of bits delivered per second, while the meaning of baud rate is number of signal changed per second. The formula for baud rate is bit rate over level, where the level is always equal to 1. Bit rate and baud rate is used in calculation of bandwidth. These are the formulas to obtain bandwidth. In the first formula, you need to get the bit rate added with 2 times the change of frequency, while in the second formula, you need to get the baud rate and add it with 2 times the change of frequency. To get the bit rate, you need to multiply the modulating signal's frequency with 2. While to get the change of frequency, first you need to identify the frequency of 2 carrier signals. Then you need to get the difference and divide it by 2 to get the change of frequency. FSK has its advantages and disadvantages. For its advantage, it has lower probability of error and good accuracy, and it is also provides high SNR, signal to noise ratio, which is easier for noise cancellation process. It also has higher immunity to noise due to constant envelope. FSK transmitter and FSK receiver implementations are simple for low data rate application, while the disadvantages are it uses larger bandwidth compared to other techniques, and the bit error rate performance in AWGN channel is worse compared to other techniques. I hope this information are useful. Thank you for watching.